And welcome, everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube, for some more Ephemeral Aggro. We did play this deck the last time that we played, but it was a lot of fun to play. It was super fast and aggressive, and it looked really good. But I wanted to make one change, and so we're going to go ahead and play it again. Plus, you know, playing four decks a day, I don't really have, you know, that many decks yet with Legends of Runeterra. But the change that I want to make is playing a couple Dark Water Scourges. We didn't have any of these last time. But just playing other games, I've had people playing these Dark Water Scourges against me, and they've looked really good. We already had the Death Marks. They could remove the Ephemeral from them. So let's just give them a try. Like, you know, they can be 3 mana, 5/5 lifelinkers that are Ephemeral. I'm putting 2 in the deck. We had 0 before, and so to make room for them, I'm taking out 2 Greenglade Duos and 2 Haunted Relics. Oh, well, we're going down to 2 for each of those. We're taking out 1 of each. So I'm just cutting 1 Duo, 1 Relic to make room for them. But yeah, this deck is still super, super aggressive. You can see our curve. We just added a couple of 3 drops, but it's all 1, 2s, and 3s besides our 2 Hecarims at the top. Probably should have 3 Hecarims, but I don't have 3 yet. But yeah, the deck's really sweet. So we're just trying to attack with a whole bunch of Ephemerals. Shark Chariot is kind of our best card. It's what our deck's built around. Every time we attack with an Ephemeral ally, Shark Chariot comes back attacking. I was really impressed last time with Silent Shadowseer. I wasn't sure, you know, how good this card would be, but I really liked it the last time we played. But there we go. So that's our deck. Let's give it a try. Oh, actually, you know what? I'm gonna put the duo back. I'm gonna take out a Shadow Fiend. That's what I'm gonna do. The Shadow Fiends were pretty hit or miss. And I guess the one thing I like about Greenglade Duo is it gives me something to play on their turn, because, you know, a lot of this Ephemeral stuff you want to play on your, like, whenever you're attacking. So actually, I'm gonna take out 1 Shadow Fiend instead of the duo. Alright. Anyway. Here we go. Let's play some Ephemeral Aggro. Let's see. Ephemeral Aggro. Ranked. Let's go. All right, I'll update our deck list. Would that change now? I'm going to be adding a duo and taking out a Shadow Beam. Well, this hand looks good, so I'll keep it. No, they haven't released it. They haven't set an. They don't have an official, fully released date. What I saw is they said it's supposed to be released the first half of 2020. So. You know, that'd be in the next 4 months. And whenever it does fully release, they're expecting it to be available on mobile also. So it should be a mobile game first half of 2020.
Pledge yourself to the shadows.
Oh, so they're mono Shadow Fiend over here. So they're sacrifice spiders. Which is probably good for our Scourges. But for now, before we start doing the Scourges, I want to, because, you know, we can play defense with these things. I want to get this other Shark Chariot out here. They're just passing. They gotta be holding up tricks. Yeah, I mean, they're definitely holding up tricks, but. So Zed's probably gonna be dying. That's fine, like, because they're, you know, they have like the
stay a while
black spear. Whoa, talk about what I was not expecting. Why would they kill Elise instead of killing the spiderling? I don't know. I don't know what just happened there. Okay, yeah, every day, Jay Rockefeller. Yeah, that's what I'm doing every day. So Thresh does have Challenger, which is kind of annoying. So I can't just, you know, play a Scourge for defense because they get to steal whatever they want. Because why suffering? Legends of Runeterra is just an amazing game. I wrote about it here. I'm a big believer in this game. Wrote about it today. Cool, yeah. Hey Gibbs, it's going good.
Sure is dark, eh?
We about to attack for a lot.
Let's move.
I could have had another Shark Chariot, but you can only have the six creatures attack in. Deal 3 to each enemy that was summoned this round. Okay. This is still a 6-1. Elusive. Ooh, up to gold 1. Let's see if Ephemeral Aggro can get us through gold 1. Hey, Jay Rockefeller. Thanks for that resub on Twitch Prime. I just changed the name today, and so because of that, my notifications are kind of messed up, but they're not working yet. But thank you so much there, Jay Rockefeller. All right, base and control. I just don't want them to play. You know, Heimerdinger or Karma on turn 5, right? Like that, and I also want to draw a Shark Chariot. I guess I have two things that I want. Shark Chariot. No. We're just going straight burn. I'm gonna go with this and the Shadow Seer. And then I have the Mark of the Isles to protect the Shadow Seer from a burn spell. And try to hit him and get a new Shadow Seer. No! That takes down my Shadow Seer plan.
Things better with company.
Says you.
You cannot escape.
Interesting. I was thinking they were doing that because then they would put the put it down to one, and then they'd have the four mana spell that does one to two different things, and they'd try to do one damage to each of these. Hey, what's up, Boo? We're holding up good. Been doing pretty well. Oh, we're 1-0 right now with the Ephemeral Aggro. I have it at 0-0. No. Shadowseer goes back to being a 3-1.
Pledge yourself to the shadows.
Yeah, Shadowseer is just like a repeatable burn spell, basically. You want to spend two mana, do three to them, put it back in your hand, and be able to keep repeating that action. And then, you know, it has just the upsides of it. It dies, so it triggers Prankster. It brings back Shark Chariot. Yeah, and then if you have the Death Mark that removes the Ephemeral and gives it to something else, it's even better. That was a pretty early Will of Ionia. They're pretty dead. Pretty dead. Okay. And they're still pretty dead.
Only the worthy survive.
Victorious. I haven't really tried a Yasuo deck, no. I think I have... I either have one or two Yasuos. I don't have all of them. Alright, looks like control again. Nope, never mind. Oh, it's the Fearsome Midrange. We were like 1-1 against Fearsome Midrange last time. I'm gonna keep this combo.
How'd you do that?
Stop. What's that sound? Attack. All right, just gonna bank the mana.
I pull the strings.
Braggart.
Now you've gone and upset it.
Okay. Sing songs. Yeah, I could save it. And keeps them from attacking and doing all this damage to me.
Out from the darkness.
But then I don't have six mana this next turn. I need six mana total for this combo. Definitely see them just taking it. Yep. Oh! Right, I have to do that first. Oh my gosh. I am... not good. Oh no.
My true beauty is beneath your skin.
Alright, well... I'm gonna blame that on... I don't know, something that was not my fault. So... Whoopsie daisy. That was me not being used. That was my first time ever like playing that card. So that's what I'm gonna blame it on, even though I've played Deathmark and Ephemeral stuff before. That's not a very good blame. Ooh, killing the ally to draw. Two, okay.
Without a sound.
Bleh. Yeah, maybe I should have second death marked. I kind of want to save like the second death mark because I wanted to pair it up with this Mark of the Isles. Alright, yeah, it was just... probably just a mistake by me. Yeah, I mean this game was lost with my 5/5 play. Like that was the card that if I would have just kept that 5/5 around, we would have had a chance. But it was pretty lost after that. Plus all the other cards that my opponent played. All right, 2-1. Gotta play better. Gotta play better. Yeah, Rekindler plus plus Hecarim is definitely a really good combo. Alright, so this is the War Mother's Call deck, right? They're just trying to play a late game. This is a good combo here. You know, it only costs 4 mana to play the Shadow Fiend and then Deathmark it. Okay, so yeah, they're trying to catalyst of Aeons. Alright, so that ramps them. Expecting avalanche. We got the +3/+3.
Shadow take you.
You're gonna play a creature that can kill, that can deathmark. Dang, heal an ally 7, draw a card. That's a lot of life. Got real punished for just playing that instead of just playing the, you know, could have like double or triple spelled. This is exactly how they want the game to play out. They're at 18 this late in the game. They obviously could just have another Will of Ionia and kind of blow this up. Yeah, or deny. Okay, Soul Shepherd's pretty good. This is definitely the matchup for Shark Chariot. It's gonna be okay. Nope. No! Wrong one! I was trying to play the Shadow Fiend. Well, I wanted to play the Shadow Fiend here, not the Shadow Seer. With them having the blocker. We are putting a lot of pressure on them, though. It's a lot of big creatures. Yeah, Hex Bomb, this game is awesome. Bleh. There goes my Shadow Seer. Yeah, this game's awesome. I wrote about it today, of why I really like it and why I recommend people playing it. Summon the top unit. Yeah, so War Mother's Call. So summon the top unit of your deck now and the start of each round. Oh, that's like probably the worst thing for them to hit, I imagine. Oh, there you go. Ramen inspired you to finally craft the Shark Chariots. You had the three Hecarims. Nice, yeah, the Shark Chariots are awesome. Yeah, this doesn't... Huh. So I can keep on playing more creatures. Maybe I'm not supposed to do that. Yeah, don't have to worry about Ruination. I think, isn't it the slow card that frostbites everything? I think it's slow speed. I think.
Stay back. Stand and defend.
Does it go to 11 or? Still dead.
Next time.
Save the host.
All right, 3-1. We're so close. Is that the name of the card? Winter's Breath. Slow speed. Frostbite everything. Alright, we got Ezreal control this time. It's a good card to see.
these moves.
Come, the journey ahead is long.
Knocked and ready.
Boo.
And punch.
Yeah, I'll just trade.
I'll protect the villages.
That was a good turn for them. Ah! Let's get that out of here. Yeah, Sharp Chariot. Best card. Need more Shark Chariots.
It's playtime.
Shark Chariot. I think I'm gonna save the Shadow Seer so I can have like these things to protect Shadow Seer. Because I, you know, definitely want to hit them with Shadow Seer. I don't want them to just Mystic Shot kill it. You know, if they had Mystic Shot, they probably would have killed this 2-2. Oh, there is the Mystic Shot. Okay, they're killing the 0-2.
I'm swinging.
My life for Avarosa.
These Icefield archers have been awesome for them. You don't like this version of the deck? We've done really well every time we've played this. By every time, I mean last time we were 6-2, today we're 3-1. So we're 9-3 with the deck. They had an awesome hand for sure, but yeah, I mean.
Night falls. Shadows gather.
Yeah, this is the second time we've gotten Elnucked today.
Do not fear the shrouded path.
Yeah, the Elnucks are really good. That's the second time, you know, that's second time our opponent played a troop and got three others. So the last time that we saw somebody play a troop, they got three others. That's twice in a row that happened now.
Winter take you.
Gosh, these archers have just destroyed me.
pleased if I'm in mushroom.
So it'd have been a lot better if I would have hit them down to four and had another Shadow Seer. Those three archers really hurt.
You have nothing to gain.
Yeah, it's still seven. GG's. For a control deck, they basically only had anti-aggro creatures, and it worked very well. Alright, so 3-2. Thanks, Eric. Thank you so much.
Today's lesson.
Yeah, Legends of Runeterra has been really fun to play. I wrote about why I like it more than Magic today in that Google Doc. And hope more people try it out, because yeah, it's been awesome.
The shadows take form.
Go, Shadow Seer.
Victory requires a sharp blade.
I know it's kind of better to save those for the Prankster, but we got another one, and I'm a little worried about this Prankster with them having a Glory Seeker now. So I'm going to get aggressive. Oh, right. Yeah, the 5-1 can't block. Yeah. But worried about that thing killing this. Bleh. That's why I shouldn't have played the 4-3. I was thinking that this was going to be safe. But it was not safe. I guess I shouldn't have played the 4-3. Alright, so I just wasted three cards and dealt three damage. I did trade with three of their cards, but
I need just a moment.
Yeah, that's kind of a waste.
I'll cut them up, face me!
Alright, I probably didn't play this game the best.
Left foot, left foot.
It's playtime.
Yeah, I don't think I played this game the best.
Our strength is yours.
Night falls. Shadows gather. Shadow take you.
Please don't have a spell.
This is our homeland.
It gets rid of my 3-1. Alright, gonna move on to the next game. Cause if we get that far behind, we're not coming back. We are very, very aggressive. These two opponents did not. We need to have people stumble just a tad. I don't know if I'm supposed to get rid of this Spectral Rider, maybe. Maybe Spectral Rider, Prankster, maybe I should be replacing these two. Yeah. No Frozen Vessel, yeah, I completely understand that. Yeah, the card's costing a fortune in magic, and then, yeah, like Teferi Time Raveler, that kind of, yeah. Completely understand. Understand that. But yeah, Byler, why didn't the name change? I just kind of wanted to take MTG out of the name. I wanted my name to be able to be used with any card game, or just any game. All right, we got 2-for-1.
Do not fear the shrouded path.
And we got our champion.
The order rewards its faithful.
Do not deny it. Only the worthy survive.
All right, so they just took it.
Do not fear the shrouded path.
I walk your path.
All right, so they have their own Zed. Yeah, they let my Zed flip.
They cannot hide.
I have many things.
And that's why. So I'm gonna let theirs flip, but then I'll use Black Spear to kill theirs.
My skill is unrivaled.
Inglewood Jacks, I don't know, not at least for a while. I think Legends of Runeterra is just a really well put together game, and I've been want to expand with this game right now.
Willing and learn.
silent as death.
Hey, Krabby!
That's my resting face.
I would like to get rid of these elusives before playing the Shadowseer. Of course.
Cannot escape.
I didn't need to play this to fog the Zed damage.
Master.
They're not gonna outrace me. I don't care that I just took 6 from that Zed. I care about dealing more damage to them. The prankster being out here. You know, we just did a little bit of damage and I still have these things to attack with. Like, unless they give this thing lifesteal. Really difficult. SP, Spiler, yeah, definitely. But it's life. Wait, this just kills him. Yeah, unless they have Rally. Oh, I guess, so maybe I should have done the Shadows here. Oh, do they have Rally? Please don't have, they have Rally. Guess I should have done the Shadows here.
Cannot hide.
Well, these games are fast. I'm gonna play some more. Plus we're only 100 XP away from that thing. So that rally meant that they got to attack again. Ugh. SRN, that was your fault for saying rally incoming. That's why they had a rally. They wouldn't have had rally if you wouldn't have said that. That's how it works. Well, we got our best card, Shark Chariot. Unfortunately, we're not attacking turn 2, so we'll want to play the duo.
Hey, Krabby!
That's my resting face.
So they've just played nothing. They want, like, Fiora with protection backup. Yeah, they do have Fiora.
River shape the land and give it life.
Full speed ahead.
We go.
River Shaper is another great one to try to protect. So, Sleepy J, you're confused by the new name. Well, Hawkeye
currents, pull them down.
Was my cat that's been on stream for the last... If I use this, I'm basically just doing 1 mana, deal 6 damage to them. Maybe get better use out of it.
What form will the waters take?
Yeah, Hawkeye was my cat that is like the stream mascot. Yeah, he passed away last month. And of course, I wear a tie, so kind of put those together.
Step lightly.
Yeah, having Mark of the Isles with Deathmark, having those two together is a nice combo. Also, so they basically have, like, deny to keep their thing from not getting ephemeral. Like, if they block and try to use, like, barriers and stuff like that, I don't think any of that helps. I think they need to have deny. So deny costs 4 mana. They have 6, so I want them to play something that costs 3 or more. That'll do. Yeah, Will of Ionia also. That which also costs 4 mana. Oh, I thought this was the... I was thinking that was going to be like the 2/3/2s. But oh well. We're pretty close to leveling up Hecarim. What do they have at 2 mana that's going to save this thing? I'm not sure. It's like keeping the Green Glade duo alive. Hecarim leveling is a myth. No, it's not a myth. Yeah, I could have used Deathmark instead of the Mark of the Isles, but Deathmark's still pretty valuable. I'm gonna keep it around, because yeah, Deathmark can get rid of something like Karma. Or anything else. Hecarim level. All right, what you got, opponent? Got a lot of spells over there, or a lot of cards. We know at least one spell that they just got from Karma.
I pity you.
Act with conviction.
Hecarim does trample. A lot of people forget about the trample. Okay. I wasn't actually sure how that was going to work. Yeah, probably didn't need to do that. Probably should have just used Black Spear to kill it. I honestly just wasn't sure how that was going to work. I was thinking that maybe like it would strike like one, you know, like how combat is left to right. Maybe it would strike one thing left to right and then it would kill it and then not strike the other stuff.
Strength and grace.
There's a chance that happened at least. All right, so they'll kill Hecarim. Whoa, not killing Hecarim. Okay, never mind. They want to get the kill with Fiora. They have to have, like, removal for Hecarim then, right? You know, their deck doesn't seem like one to play a lot of removal. Yeah, really surprised they didn't kill Hecarim. Actually, they got these two. They had two protection spells also to keep Fiora alive.
Protect House Lore.
Like, I guess they had, like, Judgment, maybe? Maybe they just had, like, another Judgment that's what they were trying to set up, is Fiora plus Judgment. With some protection spells. Yeah, that's my guess, too, is they were banking on a second Judgment. For the surprise win. All right, get back. All right, back to gold one. Barely gold one. Yeah. We get an epic card. Upgrade to a champion. Nope, did not. When I'm targeted, draw one. Costs a lot of mana, but has a lot of draw potential. All right, gotta break the tie. Oh, and it's elusive? Let's get rid of these things. New cards. Ooh, love it. Alright, last time we tried, like, I messed up the Scourge-Deathmark combo in, like, this kind of matchup, and then we lost really bad, so I'm going to try to not mess up the combo this time. But no guarantees. I could still mess it up for sure. Whoa, still attacked with both? Hmm. Yeah, I don't know what they were doing there. Unclear what they were doing there. Take the 2-for-1 and the 5 life. So we just got rid of 4 of their spells with 2 of our spells. That's usually pretty good.
Everything's better with company.
Says you.
I am the light beyond
life. Now we have the same number of cards in hand. We got the 2 things in play. I guess it's possible they're playing Dawn Speakers. I'm not sure. So that's 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Should be game. Oh, I'm one off? No, I'm one off. Oh, it's whenever you summon the ally, grant it +1/+1. It doesn't just get +1/+1 when you make it ephemeral. Like, it's not just +1/+1. Oh, I see. I was thinking the shepherd was gonna. That's where I had my math wrong. Crap. Well, then, yeah, obviously I messed that up. Okay, well, learned something. All right, so if they attack out, I take 6. Yeah, right now if they take out, I take 6, but I gain 5, so I go down to 1, so that we can still have the Shadow Seer. Okay.
My shield is yours.
All right. Well, now, and another 2 drop. Now I have to waste this thing.
Am I flesh or shadow?
So I have to draw 1 damage. Oh, barrier, they don't gain life. You don't life steal off barrier. Alright, well, another mistake. Well, still learning. Yeah, still learning. Yeah, I guess, yeah. Don't life gain off of the barrier. But yeah, I guess I was still dead. Yeah, I was gonna take 7. Even if I would not have blocked that thing, I would have taken exact lethal. Even if I would have blocked something else. So yeah, I was dead there. Alright, well, should have won that one. And so yeah, even though we went 4 and 5, I feel like this deck's really good, and I feel like either we kind of got unlucky in a couple of games, but I also made mistakes in some of the games. You know, some of those losses were my fault, and a good amount of them. You know, it's still a tricky game, and this is a deck where you really need to sequence well. But yeah, we did really well with it last time. Were the Scourges worth it? I don't know. The Darkwater Scourges? I don't know. I don't know if this was an upgrade over the just playing another Haunted Relic and Shadow Fiend. I feel like it probably was. But I don't know. We'll have to play some more and you know, keep testing that out. All right, but there we go. So that's Ephemeral Aggro. Tomorrow, it's the new week with Legends of Runeterra, where we are going to be cracking open our vault. It unlocks, you know, there. So we'll be, you know, crack open the vault. And then we'll have our expeditions reset. So we're going to be getting a lot of new cards, you know, from the vault, from the expeditions and stuff. So tomorrow we'll be doing 2 expeditions, 2 decks. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursdays are expedition days. All right, but that's it here for Ephemeral Aggro. Hope you learned a lot too, with this being a new game. If you're watching on YouTube, hit that like button over there. I'd really, really appreciate that, and you know, leave those comments, both of those. All right, but thank you so much for watching some Ephemeral Aggro, and I'll see you for the next video.